All right, guys, gonna do something a little different. We've only got about 2 hours left, so we'll try to sneak in one more vlog. So I'm gonna pick up a rod, kind of maximize just having baits in the water to catch a few more fish. I'm throwing a chatterbait. Luke, what are you gonna be doing?
I'm gonna be flipping and throwing the BBC, the big bladed chatterbait.
Okay.
I really think this is all about you wanting to fish, and it's gonna turn into a competition here is what's gonna happen.
Well, you know who's gonna win that, though, so it goes without saying, so.
Do we?
Yeah.
How do we know this?
Because I'm fishing against you, so you know I'm gonna beat you. What's the winner gonna get, then?
I think losers should have to serve the winner drinks all night.
I'm down for that.
All right, sounds good, I'm thirsty.
I like it. Let's stick around and see what happens, guys. The wind's really picking up, got a few hours left, but we'll try to catch a few fish and get a vlog done here.
BBC. Nice. Yep, Corey, you behind already? seem to like that thing moving slow. The big bladed chatterbait by Z-Man. It's a bait Brian Thrift designed, and it's an oversized, oh no, Corey's got one too. Anyway, really cool chatterbait, vibrates like crazy. You go to a regular chatterbait, it feels like a swim jig after throwing that bait right there. Razor Shad's trailer, and probably my new favorite rod in the line, the NRX Plus, the 883 BJR bladed jig rod. It was designed just for bladed jigs, chatterbaits, and obviously it works. It's a really fun rod to throw.
Hey, what's up, baby? Being behind? I think you're behind now, buddy.
Oh, come on now.
Whose is bigger?
Yeah, yours is a little bigger.
Yeah, on the jackhammer.
Thanks a lot,
I'll show you up a little bit.
Yeah, I see that. That was fun.
Yeah.
That was good to catch a couple nice fish. Let's get another one.
Yeah, let's go. So when would you throw the BBC, right?
BBC,
BBC, yeah. Over the regular jackhammer or chatterbait? Where's that kind of?
Big bladed chatterbait's what it stands for. Okay. It really excels in dirty water. You get conditions where there's a lot of turbulence. It puts off a lot of water displacement, vibrates extremely hard. So, I mean, it's also good for big fish. It's a bait that moves a lot more water. You're probably not gonna get as many bites. There's a lot of times you're not gonna catch as many of those 2-pounders on it, but you're gonna catch those better ones. And, it really excels when those big fish can find it. Early spring muddy water is one of my favorites, but man, you see out here, it'll work like this in the thick grass when the wind's blowing as hard as it is. It's a different
bait.
It's almost like comparable to a Colorado bladed spinnerbait versus a
willow leaf. That's kind of cool, yeah. So not necessarily just a springtime thing or even a summer or wintertime thing, it's just kind of...
No, I don't think it's time of year dependent at all. It's when those fish are shallow enough to be able to reach them with it. I wouldn't throw if it's slick, calm, and sunny and clear water. But it's a conditional bait, you know, it's something that's a bigger bait and it's gonna get those bigger bites, and any time of year you can catch them on it.
Is this a 5/8 size or what weight is
this? This is a 5/8 I'm throwing here, yeah. That's the size I probably throw more than anything.
They make different sizes, you know?
Yeah, I believe it's a half 5/8 and 3/4, okay, if I remember correctly. And I like the 5/8. This blade, a half, it really rides pretty high. There's a lot of water. This blade's almost twice the size of a jackhammer blade. So. It moves a lot of water, and it's hard to get it down if you get them very light, but again, it's a great early in the morning. You know, it'll probably be a great nighttime fishing bait too.
I don't really
night fish that much, but I'm sure they'll eat it when it's like that, dark, cloudy, rainy.
I was gonna cast there. Yeah.
Well, too bad, you've already cast it.
I'll just cast over you.
You already poached one of my fish while I was talking.
So I mean, I've got about 4 pounds.
You got about 3 pounds, I got about 2.5.
Whoa, 2.5.
What?
If mine's only 3 and yours is 2.5, I think we need to call the judges out on that one. And
what do you think they were?
I'd say mine's at least 3.25, 3.5, and yours is 2.25. I think I'm up a pound.
Right.
Huh?
Come on now.
I think I'm up a pound. Good old big into the cast. Uh-oh.
Look at that. I was trying to get that grass off, and before I knew it, I had a big old bass on the end of my BBC.
Naked my fish, huh?
I don't know if that'll... What, again, another double? What are the odds of this? Why are we not stopping? It's too deep for the poles. Can I let this one go so I can catch one?
No, you gotta wait till we compare sizes here.
Let what?
Get them on camera, because you're trying to cheat already.
Cheat? They're the same.
Same?
I think they're the same. No, mine might be a little bigger.
Same. They're
mine's
same.
Mine's bigger.
Same size. Bigger. Nope, I heard them say same. Get your damn.
I think we're about at a dead heat right now.
No way.
Oh yeah, that's a half pound bigger than yours than I was last time. Look at that little thing.
You're saying the difference between these two are the same as last time?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, you're full of it right there.
Come on now.
It is pretty funny with another double though, huh?
I know. You go that long and not catch one, we get another double. That's the bad thing about this challenge. Right now, you're fishing a bait that at times will catch more fish than, and bigger fish than this bait.
Well, so far, I've caught just as many fish and bigger fish, so if it's the bait or is it...
One of them was bigger, the other one, mine was bigger.
Oh, who has overall weight though?
Me.
Oh God. You, oh, wow.
But you have the potential all the time to catch more little ones on that bait than this bait.
You are the reason they have to have officials in your boat for MLF because you just lie.
I say, I kind of feel like I'm at an advantage now though.
Heck yeah.
I can cast into the wind and don't get backlashes.
Uh-huh. Oh, s***.
Did it break off?
I think so, yeah.
Oh, look at that one foil when it came off of it. Oh, it's got me in the grass. It feels like my...
You want some help?
No, it's giant.
Giant? Yeah, giant, huh? Boxing out. Oh, watch me put your rod butt there, buddy. Oh, man.
Uh-huh.
Oh. Wow.
Throw it. It's getting abusive now. Oh, nice little bass.
It's about a
BBC.
8 ounce, 8 pounder, or 8 ouncer. According to Luke, 8 pounder.
8 pounder. Corey's getting a little sour now. He's getting further behind all the time. Let this guy go so I can get a little further ahead. I really thought that was gonna be a big one. They get you in that high drill and it's just like so much weight.
So pretty typical, I mean, chatterbait style fish. We're trying to get it in the grass, kind of snapping it out.
It is.
And I'm using the 893. That's the one you gave me, the older NRX 893.
Mm-hmm.
I guess, why do you like that rod for chatterbaits in general? And then what's the difference with that rod and why the rod you got going on there?
That was a rod I used to throw for chatterbaits a lot. It was 893. And working with the guys at Loomis, we came out with the BJR, bladed jig rod, 883. Just a little bit shorter, similar action. It really loads well. And that's the thing with the chatterbait, you don't want that bait to rip out of the mouth. The blade opens their mouth. So you need a rod that's gonna give a lot when you pull into it, but you still need that backbone down here to get them out of grass and stuff like that. So really a good rod for a chatterbait in most all situations. I'll throw this rod here, the 883 is my new go-to rod. And like I said before, it's probably one of my favorite ones in the line. It's just a very defined taper in the rod, so there's points that really break over as you load the rod more. And that first 30% of it, soft enough, you're gonna hook the fish well with the chatterbait.
And that's the NRX Plus series, or is that just in that rod, or are they making another series too, do you know?
You know, it comes in IMX Pro also.
Okay.
This is the NRX Plus, and that, those are the two it's gonna come in here to start with. I don't know what the future holds though. You know, a lot of guys throw a chatterbait and they wanna stay above the grass. Like, if I'm not hitting anything, I'm slowing it down until I hit something because I want it to pop out of that grass. I want it to keep moving. I don't want it just burnt over the top of the grass. It's something that you're getting a lot of those fish that are sitting next to those clumps to react to it.
And, it's not really the retrieve speed of the, it's really the retrieve to get it down in the grass so you can get it and snap it
exactly.
out.
Exactly. I mean, there's times that you may be fishing a lot deeper and just barely turning the handle, but if you're not hitting anything, if it's grass, I'm slowing it down. I want to get it to load up in that grass. Where you gotta think, there's a fair amount of stretch in fluorocarbon out there that far away, and it pops out of the grass, that bait springs forward and stalls out, and those fish, that's so often when you get the bites. And also a big reason you need to throw a 7-to-1 reel. You know, I throw a little faster reel with it. I don't like a 6-1 or slow reel because it's hard to catch up to them at times. When it pulls over that grass, so often they come and eat it and just come right at you and you're slack lined. And I like to really use the reel as much as I can to hook the fish, get that rod to load, blade to come out of their mouth, and get good hook placement. What? Come on, right next to the boat?
Yeah, right next to the boat, like 2 feet of line out.
There's not even hardly any grass out here.
So I've definitely got you on weight now.
Well, you beat me now. You're ahead of me by about 2.5 pounds.
2.5, I like that, yeah.
Finally agreed with me.
So we've got 2.5 pound lead. You've got one more fish tonight on the count.
Well, had one more fish.
Oh! Yeah. Oh, come on now. He's already in the boat.
Oh, you almost hit me with it, broke my rod.
2.5 pounder, too.
Okay. 2.5. Come on. Wow. Wow. Yeah.
Jeez.
I'll call that a pound and a quarter.
That big blade chatterbait has a big hook in it, but.
They eat it, though, huh?
Yeah, I mean, it hooks them like incredibly well. Yeah, they really. That one just slacklined me. That's pretty fun right there.
What makes, I mean, the chatterbait's a great post-spawn, pre-spawn bait, just because it's the bluegill imitation of it, or,
it imitates so many different things that the chatterbait does, and we've seen in tournaments over the years, it's a player in most tournaments anymore, unless it's an offshore event. Chatterbait's somehow a player in most events, and, you know, it's so versatile. You can fish it through grass, you can skip it under docks, you can do so much with it. You can imitate a crawfish getting through the water as it's coming through there, a shad, a bluegill, you know. Obviously here we're throwing baits that are bluegill colored, because that's what we're seeing around here is a lot more bluegill, but the shad spawn's going on right now in a lot of places in the country, and it's hard to beat a white one right now, whether it's a Tackle Warehouse Custom, a Jackhammer, a BBC, they all catch fish, and it's almost all year anymore. I say anymore, I think people just are throwing them more and more than they used to, and there's not a place in the country, there's not a lot of fish caught on a chatterbait of some sort.
Sure.
Oh no! Oh,
another 1 pounder! Another 1 pounder! Or pound, oh, according to the pound and a half, that's
new. Oh! That's like 6 ounces.
Yeah. Oh, 6 ounces.
Now you're up to 12 ounces ahead. I don't know if that's 6 ounces.
That's a pound right there, according to you.
Oh, come on! Look at that thing, that was fry 2 months ago.
So 4 ounces, yeah, I'll call it 8, if I had 12-ounce lead. 12-ounce lead, and more importantly, I think we're even for numbers, 6 and 6, or 5 and 5, something like that. I think so. Oh, you might have me one more fish.
I'm kind of surprised. I thought you would have caught more fish and smaller ones on average than myself, but I've caught plenty of little ones on this BBC also that definitely puts off a lot more water. A lot bigger profile.
You run the same trailer on these, or?
I do. Yeah. I throw a razor shad, Z-Man razor shad, or a diesel minnow, almost all the time. Are the two trailers I really like on a chatterbait. Oh, there's times in the spring I'll throw a turbo cross if I really want to slow it down. But you know, once the water gets warm, this straight tail trailer, it gets a lot of bites. And the razor shad's super durable, has amazing action, and. I really don't know what else I'd put on the back there. It'd be any better. There's guys that put like a jerk shad on the back of there, you know, a soft jerk bait. It's similar to this, but this one casts better, being flat, skips really good too with that razor shad. It's a huge difference skipping docks with this versus a lot of trailers. Just that flat profile really gets it to slide across the surface.
What about throwing like that new goat, like rigging it sideways or kind of like?
You know, I played with that a little bit. Yeah. I've caught some fish on it. I still, this is my number one trailer for me, but that goat, I've caught fish on it, and the unique thing about that is rigging it vertical versus horizontal, it has a lot better action.
Yeah.
Something with the blade gets those tails to kick a lot more when they're vertical versus laying side by side there as a trailer on any chatterbait. Whoa, look at that gator. The way the wind's been blowing would just be like guaranteed.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's got me in the grass again.
Oh, I hope you can get him out.
Uh-huh.
8 ouncer again?
No, that one's bigger. That's like a 12 ouncer. That puts me up by 6 ounces.
Now we're even. No, I was up by 12.
Oh, okay. So we're even again?
Yeah, even Steven.
Yeah. What do you got?
I don't know.
Dang.
I think I got about a pound and a half lead.
No.
Nice. Daniel's got the drone going. Catch another one, pound and a half. Corey's up.
That's not a pound and a half. Pound and a quarter.
Pound and a quarter?
Yeah.
All right, I don't want to hurt your feelings too bad. I'll give you pound and a quarter. MLF needs to do some. Uh-oh.
What? Oh no. I just threw down there. How much were we tied before?
No, pound and a half. You were on a save last time, so
okay.
What's that, pound and a quarter?
Probably, yeah.
So two and three quarter pound, and either I'm tied or I'm one up on the fish count. We'll have to check the official fish counter on that one. Another one though, jackhammer, getting them.
Oh! What? Come on now.
That was 2¾. I'll be nice. We'll just 3¾.
Look how skinny that is. That's not a pound.
2¾.
Thing's a half a pound.
That's a 3½-pound lead. Hey, still counts though. Still fun.
We're stuck. What? Another tiny one.
Still counts though. I'll be nice, we'll call it half a pound and make it even 4.
Nice. What?
What? I thought you watched your cast right there.
I'm getting killed now. What happened?
His tail slapped me. Okay, so 5 pounds. Come on, Luke.
I need to catch a big one.
Oh, that one hit hard. Oh, man, that might be a big one once it's got me in the grass.
Grass. Yeah, it's feeling a lot lower like grass.
I'm not complaining. 5 pounds you got to make up. Uh-oh, he's looking, he's about to go on there. Sure it ain't bigger?
It might be bigger. I don't think it's giant, but no, it's not.
That's your biggest one of the day.
Oh, come on now.
Hey, that's like a 2-pounder.
That one smoked it. Pretty fish. That clear water, they get a lot more color in them.
It's out in the nice. Middle, huh?
Yeah, I just thought I'd hydrilla out here. It's kind of a little ditch running down through here.
Oh, that one rocked it there.
Oh! Oh, it was bigger than that.
I thought it was too. Okay, not as worried.
Now, 2¼, Corey?
2¼?
Wasn't that the deficit?
The deficit, yeah.
Oh, you think it's bigger than that?
No, I'm...
What? How big do you think it is?
1¼.
Oh, come on.
Yeah.
1¼, look how fat he is. He's built like you.
I'm saying.
We need a verdict.
Slightly over 1 pound.
Yes.
It's going down now, come on.
I'll give you 1¼, so it's even 1 pound deficit.
Slightly over 1 pound. That was a little one, it actually bit my bait. Dropped it. What was that on?
A frog. Come on. Can you help me out there? You're going away
from me. I'm trying to tow it out for you.
Oh, come on.
What?
What are you doing?
What? I'm helping you.
Wow, look at that. Trying to freaking hose me here. Wow. 2 pounds probably, right?
No, it's half the size of the last one I caught.
Okay, yeah, right. Okay, we'll go 1 pound, 2 pound lead. What is this frog, bud?
That is leapfrog.
Leapfrog.
That's the poppin' version of the leapfrog. The 2.75 inch frogs, that's the bigger of the two. When it gets windy like this, throwing a poppin' frog, it doesn't float across the top as much and get away with it a lot more in the wind than you can a walking frog.
You still throw a big jig down here much at all, or?
A big jig?
Like flip a jig?
Not really. I mean, this time of year, they catch them on it pretty good, and early they do before they spawn. But in our format,
I don't know if that's a good idea. Whoa, that fish came.
Oh, look at that one, Corey.
Mm.
So a 4-pounder.
4-pounder.
new Helicross coming out by Z-Man. This thing has awesome action, just on a little 3/8 ounce weight. Started pitching around, just bites are kind of slow, sporadic on the chatterbait. Started pitching around, it really wasn't very long and caught one, 1½ or so. So I'm gonna get back in the water and try to get ahead of Corey. I think I'm down by about 1/2 pound now. What's that?
Is this legal?
Standing up there?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Smart?
I don't know about smart with me running the boat and being your competition.
That would be a
just kicking on 100 right now. You'd have a hell of a time catching up to the boat too.
That
that's a half a pound.
That's half a pound?
I'll give you a pound.
That's okay, a pound. Pound and a half for you guys. We'll take it. I wouldn't call that a pound, but since you did, I'll take it. All right, guys. We got it done. So about two and a half hours to get it done and had a good time. Caught a lot of fish.
Yeah, it was fun.
I was neat. Fun. First time seeing the BBC and the new
Helicross, yeah. Threw a few different baits and just kind of went and played around with this. Wind is really easy to cover water. So we're smoking through a lot of this. You know, it's our first day here. Want to really learn what's out here a lot more. We're catching fish about everywhere we go, but we really haven't found out how to catch the big ones yet. So that's the goal for tomorrow. I think we should get a good one tomorrow, I hope.
I think so. I mean, we're out here. I mean, this is Florida, right? We all day have been saying, I can't believe I caught a good one. And the big ones live here. I mean, there's 9, 10, 12 pounders in here. And it's gonna happen this week. We caught that big one last year. You caught that one 10 plus on that weedless chatterbait. But hopefully we'll get a big one. You guys make sure to check out their gear giveaway. G Loomis Shimano and Z-Man got a really cool gear giveaway package for you guys. If you guys learned something, you enjoyed this, give us a like, share it with your friends. It helps us out a lot to get that stuff out on YouTube and get the videos out there for us. So check back next week for some more fun from Headwaters.
Yeah, hopefully you'll see some big ones next week.
It's gonna happen.
There's gonna be a lot of fish, but hopefully there's some big ones with them. It's a good time, Corey. Congratulations.
Thanks, bartender.
I appreciate it.